When Moses stood in fear and awe at the burning bush, God told him not to come any closer, but to remove his sandals, for he was standing on holy ground. God then commissioned him to lead Israel out of Egypt, but before leaving, Moses asked God what he should say if the people questioned who sent him. In response, God said in Exodus 3:14, "I am who I am, and you shall say to the people, Yahweh has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and thus I am to be remembered throughout all generations." Yahweh is the personal name of God that describes his eternal, self-existing nature as the one who is and was and who is to come. Or like it says in our Bibles, "I am has sent me to you." And here's why that's interesting. All the other names of God in the Bible are derived from a work that he performs, almost like a divine nickname. But while the other names come from something that he does, Yahweh is the personal name that reveals who he is. In fact, it was so sacred to the Jews that they refused to speak it out loud or even to copy it down in their manuscripts. Instead, they changed the spelling to take out the vowels, leaving just the four letters that in English are YHWH. Later, they actually omitted the name altogether and used the title Adonai, meaning Lord. And that practice is still kept today. The capital L-O-R-D that we see over 6,000 times in our Bibles is the translator's way of letting us know that it's the personal name of God, Yahweh. See, the Jews saw God as so holy and so unapproachable that his name couldn't be spoken or even written down. Like Moses unable to come any closer at the burning bush, God to them was inaccessible and distant. However, in the New Testament, Jesus makes a striking claim. As he gains more and more popularity, the masses begin to question who Jesus is and who it is who sent him, just like the people questioned Moses. But this time, Jesus doesn't say, "I am has sent me to you." Instead, he says in John 8 and verse 58, "Before Abraham was, I am." Jesus is unmistakably claiming, "I am the eternal, self-existing God, the great I am." And enraged by this audacious claim, the people are ready to stone him. And not long after, they did, in fact, put him to death on the cross. They think, "We're not allowed to even speak his name or even to write it down on a scroll. So how dare any man claim to be the I am? How could the great I am be a lowly carpenter from Nazareth? Or how could God be a man at all that he should approach us? And more than that, how could that man die if he really were the eternal, self-existing I am?" And the answer is, well, only if he could take it up again. Only if he rose from the grave. And so what the resurrection proves is that the great I am is not a distant, unapproachable force, but that he became flesh and dwelt among us. And even more than that, it proves that the great I am came so that you and I could be. Or like Jesus said himself in Revelation 22:13, "I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes that they may have the right to the tree of life and may go through the gates into the city of God." He is Yahweh, the great I am, who came so that you and I could be and be his forever.